Hello, hello, hello. A very warm welcome from Team LongShot AI. Now, in the earlier videos, you've seen some of our bread and butter features like Write Mo, Instruct Me, Unstuck Me. But in this video, we'll be looking at some of the more hidden features available inside the blog editor. Now, I'll be explaining what these features are and how to use them. So, without further ado, let's get started. So we are on the LongShot dashboard, and for this video we'll look at an existing blog. Let's open this one. Now, talking about the very first feature, we have the select niches feature. Now, it is one of LongShot's flagship feature, and selecting a relevant niche for your article basically helps the AI write better content for you because it gives AI better context to what you want to write. Now, LongShot provides access to 15 unique niche categories, and there's more on the way. Now, you can use it to write for a wide variety of content, and some of the niche categories include travel, personal finance, marketing, you have health and fitness, education, lifestyle, internet, and more. So if you want to submit a new niche category, you can always submit one right here. If you're worried if this AI writer will cover your niche, we've most likely got you covered. So whenever you start writing, just select your relevant niche and write away. And if you don't find your niche, no worries, write anyway. The AI is pretty smart, so it'll help you write anything. But for this article, we have a niche available. We have internet and tech. So let me select that and let's get started. Okay, now coming to the next feature, we have the generate intro feature. And as the name suggests, this feature generates an intro for the heading H1 to H4. So you can see over here, we have H1 to H4. Now, all these bold headlines are the different headings. This is the H1 tag, as you can see, and all these are H2. So using this feature is pretty simple. What you need to do is just select the text of the heading. You can either drag or you can just click it thrice to select the heading, and you click on generate intro. Pretty easy to use. Now, this is how you generate an intro. Now, if you want to generate an intro for an H2 tag, let's look at this one. Just select it and press generate intro. What you'll see over here is a box pop-up. You can even share some insights to help the AI understand the context of the intro. Now, if you want to add something, maybe some words, maybe you want to add something in your intro, maybe some keywords, or maybe you want to write something, a paragraph or a phrase, just to let the AI know what exactly you want. So you can do that and press generate, but I don't want anything. So I'll just press the generate button. See, pretty easy. Now you have three lines over here. Now, if you want to carry on, you can use the Write More feature and keep writing forward. So this feature makes it very easy for you to start your paragraph, and all you need to do is just drop the heading and generate the intro. Now, coming to the next feature, we have the Create a FAQ feature, and this feature generates the frequently asked questions for the selected phrase or the keyword. So all you need to do is select the content and click on the Create FAQ feature, just like this. So let me choose this line, and we selected and create a FAQ. So the AI will generate 7 questions related to the content you've selected. And as you can see, it was about AI. So this is the content the AI has come up with. Now you can use these questions to generate, let's say, more headlines, or maybe you want to create a blog outline, or even use this feature for the blog FAQ schema. So it's pretty easy to use. And this is how you create FAQs using LongShot. Okay, now coming to the next feature, we have another cool feature by LongShot. This is the Create a List feature, which is used to create listicles. So the idea is pretty much the same. Just select the phrase or the keyword you want the AI to create a list about and see the AI do its own thing. So in the previous step, we created some FAQs. Let's select one of those FAQs. Let's look at the very first one. What is AI content? So as I suggested, just select the phrase and click on Create a List feature. So as you can see, the AI has come up with the listicles. You have 5 points over here, which is pretty good, pretty good. So if you have a question or a statement, you can select the content and generate a list. It's pretty easy to use. Now coming to a relatively new feature, we have the claim detection feature, and as the name suggests, it detects any false claims in your content. So after you finish creating your article, or if you wish to detect any claims as you write along, you can enable the feature by clicking this button. So we have this toggle button over here, and if we click on it, you'll find that it gets activated. Now after the AI looks at the content, it shows the number of phrases that need to be checked for factual accuracy and highlights them. So the AI is checking the content for any factual inaccuracy. So after the AI looks at the content, it shows the number of phrases that need to be checked for factual accuracy and basically highlights them, as you'll see in a moment. You can use the fact check feature, which I'll be talking about next, on those highlighted lines to verify their credibility. It'll take some time. Okay, as you can see that the claim detection feature has highlighted some lines. Now, even though it's important to know that even though these lines are highlighted, they might not be factually incorrect. So it's just the AI thinks that you should check the claim of these phrases. So now you can look at each one of them. So like this one, you can ignore this one. You can also ignore this one, this one. So pretty simple. Again, this statement is more of a general statement. Also, this is also a general statement. So we can see that the claim detection has given us 14 different results. So what we need to do is we need to check for factual accuracy, and which is the next feature we will be talking about. So the fact check feature confirms that the content the AI has written is factually correct. So you know that the AI might write some content that might not be factually correct, and if you're not looked into properly, it can somehow damage your authority. So that's where the LongShot's fact check feature enters the scene. So what you do is you select the statement and press on the fact check feature. So for instance, let's select this. Now it's a general phrase, but still let's check for any factual inaccuracy. So we select this. We click on fact check, and we have this over here. Let's click on fact check. So you can see that here's the statement. We are checking for factual accuracy, and these are the various links available on the internet. And as you can see, they are talking about the same thing, that the AI can help improve SEO. AI in SEO helps improve your current SEO strategy. You can click on them and they lead you to the website. So we can see that this statement is factually correct. Now, in case if it's not correct or it's somehow a vague statement, you'll see a notification over here which says something like, this looks like a false, subjective or vague statement. So you'll know that it is factually incorrect. This is a pretty useful feature. Again, a flagship feature offered by LongShot. A pretty unique feature and a pretty important one, if I may say, when you're talking about AI writers. Okay, now looking at the penultimate feature, we have the synopsis feature, which basically provides a brief summary of the content you've chosen. So using this feature is pretty straightforward. So after selecting the paragraph or the text for the AI to write a summary about, you click on the synopsis feature. So the AI looks up to 600 characters to understand the context and generates a brief overview. So let's, okay, we have this huge paragraph, we'll just select it and we'll click on synopsis. So the AI will generate the synopsis below the selected paragraph, as you can see over here. So this is a brief overview of this paragraph. So if you want to write more about it, you can always click on the write more feature. So we use the synopsis feature when we're looking to generate a brief summary of a paragraph. But what if we are looking to generate the summary for the entire content piece? So that is where we look at the final feature in this video. So this is the generate summary feature, which is used to generate the long summaries. So basically you click over here and you go to generate summary and you click on generate. And the good thing is that you can do it at a click of a button. So the AI reads the entire content piece and generates a long summary for your content. And it's pretty easy to use, as you can see. The AI has generated a conclusion, a summary for the content piece. Now you can copy and you can paste it in the end. Just write summary and paste the content piece. Maybe if you want to bold it, you can bold it, and here we are. I think that is pretty much all about the video. If you enjoyed watching this video, then do give us a like and let us know in the comments. Now, while you're at it, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. We'll be back with some more videos. Until then, stay safe and stay real.